To the RDC's dismay, the floor of the building, which has not even taken a month since its completion, has already developed cracks, while the toilet's veranda has also developed a big crack.
The work at Kabende sub-county headquarters, where a contractor known as Kumwe Investments Limited has purely done shoulder work. In fact, this contractor, we've been engaging him for many times, correcting here and there, but now it is becoming too much. So I've ordered for the contractor to redo, especially the flooring, to redo it.
The RDC ordered the contractor to redo the whole floor. She says the act from the contractor was unbecoming and that they could not keep quiet as the taxpayers' money was being misused.
Main building and also in the latrine, which is purely unbecoming, and you cannot really keep quiet and look at such kind of work being done on a district project where you've paid money, where government has paid money, and we just look on when this is being done.
The company which was given to the tender to construct the building belongs to John Kusesemerwa, the NRM chairperson for Fort Porter and Kabarole District. The Kabende sub-county district councillor revealed that he had previously written to the district leadership expressing his displeasure on the way the works on the building were being done.
Sub-county headquarters, after, I am not a technical person, but I am a district leader who is concerned with the mandate of monitoring district project in a district. After seeing that the works done at sub-county headquarters was not in a proper condition as how it's supposed to be, I wrote to the district works committee, which is headed by now the speaker, Professor Timothy. Him and other committee members came at the scene. They supervised and found out that the works done was not, as a district committee member, we found out that the works done was not in a proper condition. We roast cow. Then cow, when he came to visit the sub-county headquarters, he found out that works done by the report from the sub-county chairperson that everything was in order, and I was against him, but the works done at the sub-county was in a proper condition.
Another issue that raised eyebrows are the teachers' houses at Kabende Primary School, which were built in 2008, 14 years later, and the houses have already been deserted by the teachers. John Kusesemerwa, the owner of the company behind the shoddy works at the sub-county, who refused to speak on our cameras, instead blamed political games and poor type of cement used. This story was compiled by Jonan Tusingwire for the news in Fort Porter.